I'm JVN Dr. Sangeeta Gautam, and my topic is today's topic is covalent bonding, and this is from inorganic chemistry. And this topic I have taught in BSc B.Ed. first semester. Now you will learn about another type of bond in which electrons are shared. Previously we have discussed here about ionic bonding and bond hypercycle. In these two topics we covered different types of ionic compounds. Today we are discussing here the molecular compounds which are formed by covalent bonding. And here we discuss about in detail about covalent bonding. Covalent bonds are atoms held together by sharing electrons between non-metals. We have discussed here earlier that ionic bonds are formed between metals and non-metals, but covalent bonds are formed between non-metals only. You can see the pictures in this slide. And where O minus and H plus ions are joined together to form this covalent bond, and where the hydrogen share one electron and oxygen also share one electron, and this picture shows the sharing of electrons here and formed a covalent bond. You can see covalent bond in this also in this picture, where this atom has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 electrons, and this is also has 7 electrons in their outermost orbital, and to fulfill their octet they share one electron from each atom, and their octet will be fulfilled by sharing of these electrons, and covalent bonding are formed here. Salt versus molecules. A metal cation and non-metal anion are joined together by an ionic bond are called salts, whereas a group of atoms joined together by a covalent bond is called molecule. These are salts and these are molecules. Basically, molecules which are formed by overlapping of orbitals and sharing of electrons, and salts are formed by cations and anions. In salts, ionic bonding are formed, and in molecules, covalent bondings are formed. A compound is a group of two or more elements bonded together, ionic or covalent bond. There is third term is compound, where two or more elements are bonded together, and there will be there may be a ionic bond or a covalent bond. You can see these pictures, and these pictures shows clearly the difference between ionic and covalent bond. This shows covalent bonding, and this picture shows the ionic bonding. In this picture, two atoms are same electronegative, and both have same electrons in their outermost electron, and these atoms by sharing of electrons and by sharing of their orbitals form covalent bond, and these compound pair formed is called molecule. In this picture we can clearly see that one atom give one electron from their outermost orbital to the another atom, and by the transfer of electron, first atom has positive charge, and second atom which accept electron from first atom gain negative charge, positive ions and negative ions will be formed there, and this type of bonding is ionic bonding. So basically this is the difference between ionic and covalent bond. In ionic bonding transfer of electron occur, and in covalent bonding sharing of electrons occur. This is also same picture. monoatomic and diatomic molecules. Most molecules can be monoatomic or diatomic. Diatomic molecules is a molecule consisting of two atoms. There are seven diatomic molecules, super 7, N2, O2, F2, Cl2, Br2, I2 and H2. Diatomic molecules, there are homomolecular atoms or homomolecules. You can also remember them as H2, O2, F2, Br2, I2, N2 and Cl2. And this is the periodic table, and where you can see the position of these homoatomic molecules, H, N, O, F, Cl, Br and I. These elements formed diatomic molecules and homomolecular. Properties of molecular compounds. Liquid and gases at room temperature, because covalent bonding is poor than ionic bonding, so the physical state of covalent compound is liquid or gas. Lower melting points than ionic compounds, which means they are weaker than ionic bond. These compounds have lower melting and boiling points. So this shows that the covalent bonding is weaker than ionic bonding. You can see the pictures of different compounds, different molecular compounds in this pictures. Then now we discuss molecular formulas. Molecular formulas of is the formula of a molecular compound. It shows how many atoms of each element a molecule contains. Example, H2O contains 3 atoms, 2 atoms of H and 1 atom of oxygen, and likely C2H6 molecule contains 8 atoms, 2 atoms of carbon and 6 atoms of hydrogen. So molecular formula shows the number of atoms which contains any molecule. Now you can practice in these molecules. How many atoms are there in these molecules? Like H2O contains 2 atoms, 2 hydrogen atoms, and CO molecule contains 2 atoms, 1 carbon and 1 oxygen. CO2 contains 3 atoms, 1 carbon and 2 oxygen. NH3 contains 3 atoms, 1 nitrogen and 3 hydrogen, and this is also contains 2, 6 and 1, total 8 atoms, 2 carbon, 6 hydrogen and 1 oxygen. Okay, now this picture also shows the ionic bonding compared to covalent bonding. This is formation of Na plus and Cl minus, and this is the formation of NaCl ionic bonding. And this picture shows the oxygen covalent bonding, which are bonded by covalent bond, where sodium metal gives a electron and forms sodium plus ion, and this electron gained by chlorine and formed chloride cation, chloride anion, and form NaCl crystal. Due to the electrostatic forces between cation and anion. This picture shows the covalent bonding between two oxygen atoms, where two oxygen atoms share electrons, electrons in these outermost orbital, and fulfill their octet and gain stability by covalent bonding. This table clearly shows the difference between ionic and covalent bonding. The molecules which are formed by ionic bond are normally called as salts, and by covalent bonding these are called molecules. Ionic bonding are formed by transfer of electrons, and covalent bondings are formed by sharing of electrons. these ionic bonding are formed between metals and non-metals, and covalent bonding normally occurs in non-metals. Physical state of ionic compounds are solids because ionic bonds are very strong, and physical state of covalent bonded molecules are solid, liquid or gases. They may be solid, liquid or gases. Melting points, if we compare between ionic compounds, are very high, above 300 degree centigrade, and covalent molecules have low melting points, below 300 degree centigrade. These are ionic compounds are soluble in water because the nature of water is polar, and the nature of ionic compounds are also polar. So polar compounds are easily dissolved in polar solvent. Same phenomena is worked here. So mostly ionic compounds are dissolved in water. Likely covalent molecules are not dissolved in water or any polar solvents. They are non-polar, or so they dissolve in various non-polar solvents or covalent solvents like benzene, ether or PET ether or acetone, like these solvents. So next property is conductivity. Ionic compounds are very good conductors in their molten state and their melted state, or their solution state, because they have different types of ions for movement. And covalent bonds are very poor conductors. So these are the basic difference between ionic and covalent bonding. So remember that ionic compounds transfer electrons in order to attain a noble gas electron configuration, instead of covalent compounds formed by sharing electrons to attain a noble gas electron configuration. Regardless of the type of bond, the octet rule still must be obeyed, 8 valence electrons. Single covalent bond can be shown by this picture. A single covalent bond consists of two atoms held together by sharing one pair of electrons, means each atom gives one electron, and between these two atoms two electrons are shared. So a single bond will be formed by sharing of two electrons between two atoms. These covalent bonding also we can see in these pictures in Lewis structures. You can see here the first example is HCl, where H has one electron only in this in his outermost orbital, and chlorine has 7 electrons in their outermost orbital. By the sharing of one electron from these two atoms, covalent bonding are formed and octet rule will be fulfill in this molecule. Here you can see that the formation of methane CH4, where each carbon atom shared one electron from each hydrogen atom, and by the sharing of electrons they are bonded together by covalent bond and fulfill their octet. So in these you can see different pictures and different types of covalent bonding and different types of covalent compounds by sharing of electrons. These all compounds shows that the covalent bonding are formed because to fulfill the octet of the compound. Shared versus unshared electrons. A shared pair is a pair of valence electrons that is shared between atoms, and unshared pair is a pair of valence electrons that is not shared between atoms. So you can see the shared and unshared electrons in these pictures. These are the shared electrons and these are the unshared electrons on nitrogen atom. These are also known as lone pair of electrons. You can see the difference between paired and non-paired, shared and non-shared electrons in this picture. These bond shows the shared electrons between carbon and chlorine. and these are the unshared electrons. Sometimes atoms attain noble gas configuration by sharing of 2 and 3 pairs of electrons. A double bond, double covalent bond is a bond that involves 2 shared pair of electrons, that means total 4 number of electrons. You can understand these double bond by these pictures, and the example of double bond is O2, where O atom is bonded by another atom by double bond, where total 4 electrons are shared between these two atoms, 2 electrons from one atom and 2 electrons from another atom, and total 4 number of electrons shared in between these two oxygen atoms, and octet will be fulfilled by the sharing of 2 pair of electrons. You can see this double bond in CO2 compound, where carbon and oxygen share 2 electrons from every double in every double bond, and form double bond, triple covalent bond. A triple covalent bond is a bond that involves 3 shared pair of electrons, means total 6 number of electrons between atoms. You can see the example of nitrogen, where nitrogen atom bonded with another atom with triple bond. You can clearly see this picture by the sharing of sharing of 6 electrons between these two atoms. One nitrogen atom share 3 electrons, and another nitrogen atom also share 3 electrons, and total 6 number of electrons are shared here, and the bond will be formed here is triple bond. Single bond means 2 electrons between 2 atoms, double bond means 4 electrons between 2 atoms, and triple bond means total 6 electrons between 2 atoms. So this is all about covalent bonding. Thank you very much for listening and watching my video. Thank you very much.